For the stock saloons. They may look like bangers, but there's a lot of iron, a lot of strength in those cars. A lot of work has gone into them. A graded start, the white top cars you can see down at the front. Then come the yellow grade, then the blue, and then the star grade drivers, the ones with the red roof. They're the top drivers. They have the penalty of starting at the back. A greasy and rather slippery surface is what the drivers have to contend with today. Drivers from all over, including from Belgium, Dirk Pommers, you can see there. He has a gold roof, the one exception to that colour coding I've just been telling you. He's the reigning world champion, and the penalty that he has is to start at the very back of the field for every race throughout the season. That shale on top of the tarmac making the going very greasy, very slippery. And the technique is the same with this formula as with most of them. For the better drivers who have the disadvantage in some ways of starting at the back, the advantage is you can sit back and let some of the less experienced drivers get themselves in the fence and get themselves into trouble, and you can then sail past and pick up the pieces. One very competitive driver always here at Wimbledon, but he doesn't race very often at Wimbledon because he's the Scottish champion, spends most of his time north of the border, but when he comes down here he really gives all the English lads a very good run for his money. National points champion you've just seen go through there. And as they come through, let's bring in Barry Lee. A word about stock saloons, Barry.
What can I say? A word about stock saloons, as we can just see there, flash, crash, do what you really want. Actually, the world champion started right at the back. It's not too much of a disadvantage, because with stock saloons, you are allowed to eliminate the car in front of you, which you can well see now by the carnage left all over the track. Keith Jarman is going very, very well. He got held up in the first corner pile-up, but he's going very, very well indeed in Scotland. There he is, Keith Jarman, number 46.
Well, of course, the pushing and the shoving that Barry was talking about, something you are not supposed to do in the hot rod formula. Bez said, our world champion, in a little bit of bother there, finding the infield very greasy. The speedway track on the straights is on the inside, and it's very, very boggy down there, and you lose all your grip as soon as you get out there. That's Dirk Thomas in car number 37. There's five laps gone in this 25-lapper. The world champion still trying to maintain a place, but he's pretty well down the field at the moment. It's 307 who is in fact the leader. If you see him go through, 307, Dave Simpson is in the lead. In second place is 115, Alan Taylor. And the third place currently is car number 448, Terry Colliver, from just down the road in Ballam. So whether it's going to be a case of local boy makes good today, we'll have to wait and see. At the back of that little group there, Conrad Self, one of the leading East Anglian drivers. Very successful. Here's the Scotsman. Oh, and there's the world champion in the background getting a fair old biff as Keith Jarman from Scotland goes through. Look down the sheets. Keith Jarman's still a long way back. But it's still this one. Yellow grade driver, second grade driver that is. And he's got Eddie George in 226, one of the star grade men, who in fact is some way back. I thought he was actually going to poke him in the fence because Eddie George gives no quarter, doesn't expect any, I have to say, and is not averse to just pushing people out. It's the back one of those three that in fact is the leader. Eddie George has got a lot to do. 303's not going a lot further. Alan Parker from Norwich, he's abandoned ship, leaving a little bit of a chicane there, a bit of an obstacle for them to get through. And you can see that's the technique, lean on him and then try and push him into the fast car, but it didn't quite come off. There's Keith Jarman still in the thick of it there. Ray Gowdy just going through. The world champion Dirk Thomas in the back. But up front, with nine laps gone, it's still that yellow top, 307, who is there. And now comes the pressure. This is what Barry Lee was talking about. You can just give them a push and shunt them out of the way. You can't do that in the rods, can you, Barry?
No, you're not allowed to. And to make it even harder, you're allowed to eliminate people there. But, oh, look at that accident there. The reason that accident happened, because they've got no rear-view mirrors in these cars. So you can't see cars coming up behind you, because to make it more interesting and more spectacular, they made all the drivers remove their rear-view mirrors so they can pull out in front of a car coming steaming down. There's Jarman just been spun around once again. Poor Keith, it's not his day today. They're definitely out. The English boys are out to get the Scottish boys.
So Terry Colliver now takes it up, 4:48, with 10 laps gone, 4:48, 3:07, now knocked well down the placings after that shunt. 115 is in second place, Alan Taylor. 3:02, Dean Wood has now moved up into third. So those are the placings. 4:48, Terry Colliver. 302 Dingwood now second. 115 has dropped down to third. Then comes 363, and then 307, who we thought pushed into the fence. Then 156 Ray Gowdy. Then we go back to 68 from Scotland, Harry Burgoyne. Plenty of action. These cars, of course, are well and truly strengthened. There's 448 on the inside of that little group.
Dirk Thomas there in the outside has just gone out, Nigel. He's into the fence there, and he's out of the race now. Dirk Thomas, the Belgian world champion, has now gone out of the race on the far zone.
But it's still Terry Colliver with 12 laps gone as we come to the halfway stage. Goes his way round very well indeed. Just trying to keep himself out of bother. He won't mind a bit of bother if it comes along. One way of getting round the bend, you just bounce off the opposition. And if somebody starts snaking about in front of you, well, you just wait till the back end gets hung out, latch on and give a push, but then he's going to have to do it in that case. He didn't have to touch it. He did it all himself. So, 14 gone, 4-4-8, Terry Colliver from Balham. 302, Dean Wood is in second place, the reigning Southern champion from Aldershot. 363 comes third, Terry Kirby. Then it's 115, Alan Taylor. 156, Ray Gowdy. And 636, Conrad Sell. The Scotsman here, Keith Jarman, still a long way behind. Oh, and a little bit of a knock there from Harry Burgoyne from Scotland against 448. Tried to put him in the fence. Didn't do him a lot of good. Being the filling in the sandwich a little there. Dean Wood going right up on the outside now to take it up. So there we are. Oh, and more trouble right behind them. But those are the two leaders are clear. There's 302. 448 right behind him. Oh, and a bad mistake there by Terry Colliver. Out wide, and you can see the ground he's now lost, leaving Dean Wood clear.
Quite obvious what Colliver was trying to do was use Dean Wood, the car in the bottom left hand of the picture there. He was going to try and use him as a brake. Dean saw that through the side window of his car and just managed to hang the tail out. So, of course, the Colliver, the Allegro behind there, went very, very wide and across all the space.
And that's the gap you can see, and he's now trying to make it up. A bit of a steering problem there, too.
That's understeer, as we said, that cars do suffer with.
This is the leading group there. The leader already going down that straight, going up towards the top of the picture. Then you've got the second place man. 448, 363 right on his tail, and 156 in there with him. Well, coming towards the closing stages now, time running out, and Dean Wood really going very well. There's a lot of competition, especially in the southern part of the country. And to be Southern champion, you've got to know what you're doing. And that's the title held by this man in the lead on the right of the picture there. 302, Dean Wood. And there's five more laps to go as they come past the starting marshal this time. At the moment, it's looking as if Dean Wood is going to take this one if he can just hang on. 448 is still there in second place, Terry Colliver. Then we go back to 363, Terry Kirby. 156, Ray Gowdy. 636, Conrad Self. And 115, Alan Taylor. But they're a long way back, and they're going to have to really put on a little bit of speed. I'm worried about Keith Jarman here, who's a long way behind, whether in fact he's going to leave Dean Wood alone and let him go.
I think the problem they've got there, Nigel, now, the track is very, very muddy. And you can notice when we get a tight shot inside the cars there, not many of the drivers have got their goggles on now. They've taken their goggles off because they're finding it so hard to see. This is another major problem for them all.
Especially, of course, the time you need to see most is the time when you're coming up behind somebody, and that's when you get all the muck in your eyes. And there's Terry Colliver. It didn't take much of a touch to push him in, and that's 4:48. He was in second place, and now, although he's turning round,
there's miles to chase love away.
Still the leader. 119 there. I thought again maybe a little bit of hassle was going to come in there, but he let him go. Like settling an old score as the leader goes past, and you just snick him out with a couple of laps to go. He remembers. So 302 Dean Wood, three more laps to go. Now a couple of back markers which he'd like to dispose of, whether it'll be prudent to do so, bearing in mind the second and third men are quite some way back. He could afford to take it easy. Find those parked cars.
Oh, that was a lovely way of putting somebody into the fence or into a parked car. He is a great young driver, that Dean Wood, and that's superb stock car driving. That's what it's all about.
So then, Dean Wood looking set to take this one. comfortably in the lead. Round the pit turn he comes. In the closing stages, the two-lap marker out there from the starting marshal. Eddie Aldous there, 2:38, national points champion, a long way down in this field. The Scotsman really not in it at the moment. It's 3:02, Dean Wood, 1:56, Ray Gowdy, 6:36, Conrad Self. But the second and third places are some way back. It's 3:02, 1:56, 6:36, 1:15, and 4:48, Kerry Colliver has come back in again. There's the second place man. That's Ray Gowdy. Wants to get that back marker out of the way, but he's not going to have much chance to take the leader because he's already coming off the final turn. The checkered flag is now at the ready. He's going to chase the Scotsman over the line. 3:02, that's the checkered flag. And he drove well. He picked up the lead after 15 laps to take the trophy. 3:02, Dean Wood.
Yes, young Dean Wood doing so well in those slippery conditions and drawing praise from no less than Danny Lee, winning that saloon stock car race. Now, the most refined form of small oval racing is hot rodding, and we'll have the Winter National Championship for you at 2. The sophistication of an MOT test, they'll be lucky to...